I am Marion Buricatu. I am a French and American artist. I am also a teacher at the Hopkinton Center for the Art and a docent at the Worcester Art Museum. Today we will be talking about the fascinating story of the chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum with my guest and daughter, Domiti.
Hello!
Hi.
And we will be covering three facts that are very easy to remember.
Why are we talking about a boring old building again?
Thank you, Domiti, for your enthusiasm. I really appreciate it. But this story covers wars, monk life,
fascinating,
French Revolution, and an epic trip to the US. And if after this video you still think this is boring, then you'll tell me, but I'm quite sure you will think it's a fascinating story. Okay so Domiti, what are the questions?
So question number one is, what are we talking about? Question number two is, what is a priory? And question number three, how does a priory work?
Okay, so here is a picture of the chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum. It was built in the 11th or 12th century in the Western France.
Okay, so to get started with question number one, which is, what in the world are we talking about? Here's a map of the time. We can see the arrow showing the chapter house is located in Western France. It's in the pink slash purple area, and that at some point was owned by the King of England, right?
Yes, absolutely. That's correct. And do you notice also on the map the size of the French kingdom?
You mean the blue thing? Why is it so small?
Yeah, it's very small. So it's quite complicated. And I'm going to do something special because in two sentences, I'm going to give you two centuries of France history.
Okay.
So France was the battlefield of constant fighting for land between England and France. And there was a lot of switching around as France was trying to establish its nation.
Okay. And what does this have to do with the chapter house?
Thank you to reminding me, Domiti, to stay on subject.
Stay on track.
To stay on track. So because of the constant fighting, the nobility was very, very, very worried that they were going to go to hell for their sins.
Because they were switching allegiances a lot and they were killing a lot of people.
Yes,
and, okay.
Fighting for castle and land and constantly switching around. Okay, so they were very worried. And don't forget that in the medieval time, that was very important. Okay, the afterlife was a big deal. So they had a solution to solve that problem. They gave a lot of money to build priories and churches.
Okay, and still the same question, how does this relate to the chapter house?
Thank you for reminding me. So, this chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum belonged to a priory that was located very close to the castle of one of these noble families. And it was the castle of the Lord of Belleys. So here is the castle of the Belley family that we can visit nowadays. And it's located only 7 miles from the chapter house.
And that's really close.
That's really close. And it was kind of built at the same time, so I'm assuming there's a connection, and I have no proof for that.
Okay, so let's go to question number two. What is a priory?
Okay, so Domiti, let's just recap. What do you remember what I said?
Yes, that they were building a lot of religious buildings and priories because the goal was to absolve them from their terrible sins.
Yes, absolutely. So a priory is a religious community.
Okay.
And the chapter house of the Worcester Art Museum belonged to a priory called the Priory of St. John, and it had 12 monks.
That's pretty small.
Yeah, it's a small priory. Absolutely. At that time, priories were much bigger.
Okay, and what is so special about priories?
So the monks lived under a strict code of conduct. And in the case of the Priory of St. John, they lived under the rule of St. Benedict.
And what does that mean for the monks?
Okay, so it called for making books, vows of poverty, obedience, chastity, a life based on prayer and manual work. And by the way, about making books, Domiti, do you remember when the printing press was invented?
You have told me many times and I never remember.
Okay, so maybe it's the last time I'm going to tell you that.
Okay.
It was invented in the 15th century.
Okay, so 1400s.
1400.
So like 300 to 400 years
after
the what we're talking about.
Okay. Yes, absolutely. So before the printing press was invented, every book was made by hand by monks and they were illustrated beautifully. So here's an example. This is called illumination. In French, we call that enluminure. It was considered one of the highest form of artistic skill at the time.
Okay, very interesting.
Yes.
And so our last question. Nope, I take it back. Okay, so our last question, question number three, is what is a chapter house, which we still have not answered.
You're right. Okay, I hope this time I'm going to answer the question. Okay, so important to remember, okay, priories were self-sufficient. And to achieve this, they needed a few things. They needed a church. They needed a chapter house, they needed a dormitory for the monks, they needed a vegetable garden farmed animal, mm-hmm. they needed an active community surrounding the priory, and a cloister.
Can you explain what a cloister is?
Yes, I can, absolutely. Okay, so as you can see on this picture of the Royal Abbey of Fontevraud, which is similar to the Worcester Art Museum one, much but bigger. There is a church tower on the left of the picture, and a covered walk. That is the cloister. And the cloister leads to many rooms, among them the chapter house.
So what is a chapter house, Mom?
Finally, you'll get the answer. It's simple. It is just the staff room. Here is a picture of some monks in a meeting, and you can see the architecture surrounding them, very similar to our chapter house.
Okay, so that's it? We just did an entire video about a staff room.
Yes!
I thought you said this was going to be interesting!
But it is, because you imagine you go to the museum, you see this amazing room, this unbelievable architecture, and then you learn that it was a staff room.
Okay, sure. Let's do a summary of the three facts that we learned in this video that are easy to remember.
Okay, fact number one.
Fighting in France during the Middle Ages generally led to investments in religious buildings, but that is grossly oversimplified, by the way, so don't take that to heart.
Yes. Fact number two.
A chapter house is part of a priory, which is a religious and self-sufficient community.
Fact number three.
Is that a chapter house is very anticlimactically just a staff room. But we have one at the Worcester Art Museum, and that's cool.
Yay! Okay, so one last thing before we're done with this video. Every French kid in France visits priories or any kind of old buildings from the medieval time. It's every children, and I did that too when I was young. And I didn't understand how it was such a big deal until I became myself a docent at the Worcester Art Museum.
Kind of like Americans visiting Plymouth. Except yes. It's not that interesting.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And then they go to another country and they realize how the story of their country is so special.
Right.
Okay, so now you are an art expert on the historical context of the chapter house. And the next video is just for you because we created some fun trivia question about what we just said. Bye-bye.
Bye.
I am Marion Buricatu, a French and American artist. I am also a teacher at the Hockington Center for the Art and a docent at the Worcester Art Museum. In this video, we will ask you some fun trivia questions about the chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum with my guest, Domiti.
Hi. So I think I'm going to be asking the questions, so Mom will know all the answers, but she'll be able to give some additional information. Okay. So don't feel bad if you don't know everything, okay? Okay, so let's start with question number one. What is a priory? Is it a building of great importance, a place for the elderly, or a religious community?
It's a religious community.
Okay, what is a chapter house? Question number two. Is it a specific architectural style, a staff room, or a local branch of society?
It's a staff room. And in that case, it's a staff room with a specific architectural style.
Yes, but it's not a local branch of society.
No.
Okay, question number three. What country kept invading France, unnecessarily, may I add, in the Middle Ages? Was it England, the Netherlands, or Canada?
England, obviously.
We have a rivalry.
Yeah.
Sorry, Englanders.
Yeah, century-long rivalry.
Okay. Question number four. Making books in medieval times was also called 1. Book decoration, 2. Illumination, or 3. Print machining.
Okay, so it was called illumination in English, and in French, I love the French word, enluminure.
Which basically describes book decoration.
Yes, yes. But the book decoration doesn't sound great.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, question number 5. The Priory of St. John followed which rule? 1. The rule of law, 2, the rule of thumb, or 3, the rule of Saint Benedict?
Well, the rule of Saint Benedict.
Not the rule of thumb.
No. I loved it. I had a good idea with this one when I prepared it.
Okay, and last question, question 6. How many monks lived in the priory of Saint John's? Was it 12, 24, or 76?
12. And it was a small priory.
So most were what size?
So the one in the Abbey of Fontevraud that we've been talking before, it was more like 200.
Wow.
Yes, monks and monials, men and women.
Okay.
Okay, so have fun. This video is finished. Nice chatting with you and see you at the next video. Bye!